So in the other options, this brings you directly to the settings. So in the settings and under saving options, you have all different formats you can export to and the options that go with it. So for JPEG and WebP options, you can choose to put it in progressive mode. You can choose to adjust the quality for it, up in the quality or lower in it. For JPEG, you can also choose to adjust the quality of your pages for it as output method. Then for the output file attributes, you can choose to create a read-only file, an archive file, or a hidden file. These are all properties you can apply it to your page. Then you also have the author. You can choose title. These are for the PDF options. You can choose the author, the title, the subject, the keywords. Enable encryption. You can also use passwords. Enable fast view, web view. Then we come up to the compression schemes. For the compression schemes, you have either the compression scheme for bitonal images, which is usable for black and white documents, or you can also change the compression scheme for color images if you do have color images loaded in your Paperscan. Now these are very particular to Paperscan and use GT picture methods and are exclusive to our software. So all these methods will allow you to compress your pages. Now if you want to find out more about these options to optimize your file size, we suggest you check out our user guide, as it goes much more in depth than I will explain in this video. You also have an option to enable MRC compression. This stands for mixed raster content, which segments a page to apply different compression algorithms on different elements within a page. Example, if you have some text and image, they won't be compressed the same way. This option works well if you have a structured document. Then you have the PDF version, which you can choose here. We even support PDFA, as you can see here. Then you also have miscellaneous, which we previously showed in the saving options. And once you are done with all of these options, simply click save and your file will be saved.